12 now, WNBC. Well, what happens to the morning? And it was 1 year ago today, wasn't it? Isn't that something? I can tell you how choked up I am about this whole thing. I had something here. I want to hear this. Dave, then let's do them two spots at 6:12 at WNBC. I'm great. I'm Imus in the morning. This morning, you're going to hear Reverend Hargis from 1 year ago. You're going to hear Crazy Bob from 1 year ago. Imus in Washington from 1 year ago. Judge Hangin from 1 year ago. Well, you're just going to hear a whole lot of stuff.
This is Marv Albert.
Who?
A question has been posed to me. Did I think that Imus would last a year as I reflect back to a year ago at this time? I'll never forget the first time I heard Imus on WNBC. First, I thought there was some kind of out-of-town interference. I thought that some ham radio operator practicing animal impressions had somehow filtered through. But I was told that that is the new morning man. It's him. And I asked one of the engineers, what does he sound like on a bad day? Well, after my curiosity got the better of me, I investigated further. And this is something I know that Don doesn't like to talk about. But now all the pieces fit together. And I think it is very benevolent, very compassionate of the management of WNBC Radio to allow an outpatient to gain his confidence, to work out his frustrations with his very own morning radio show. The treatment, I'm told, has worked remarkably well, and it may set a precedence for future medical aid. Yes, in short time, Don Imus will be permitted to return to his semi-private room in Stockton, California. Now, how much longer do I think that Imus will last? Another question that was posed to me. That's hard to tell. It could be hours, might be days. Don, happy anniversary. Let's see now. You wanted me to say this. You dropped this note to me, and it reads, "Hi, this is Marv Albert. Don, it's just wonderful to share this memorable moment with you. A great star. May you have many more years of glorious success." Is that how you wanted me to read it, Don?
Why don't you eat it, Marv?
I have confidence in Buick. No, my husband is not connected with Buick in any way.
Wouldn't you really rather have a Buick? Wouldn't you really rather? WNBC Radio 63.
Your old friend has a new name. Come on and help us celebrate. Yes, your old friend has a new name and a great new gift for you.
Your old friend, the Esso Tiger, is changing his name to Exxon, and that calls for a special celebration.
So you're going to get a free gift every time you fill up with any Exxon gasoline, and wow, what a gift it is.
Well, don't get carried away now.
But really, it's just about the best-looking insulated cup I've ever seen.
Right.
Elegant, white on white, keeps beverages hot or cold. It's part of a new designer collection by David Douglas, created especially to celebrate the changeover from Esso to Exxon.
All you do is fill up at a participating station, and most stations are participating.
So come on and see us.
Now.
And get your free cup.
Yes, your old friend has a new name, Exxon, and a great new gift for you.
In New Jersey, no purchase is necessary. Licensed drivers only.
I'm Imus in the morning.
6:16 in New York. It's 6:18 at WNBC. We're going to talk on the telephone here in a minute. Hey, hello.
This is a recorded message. Please leave your name, phone number, and time of call. In a few seconds from now, you'll hear a beep. At that time, start to talk to leave the message.
Hi, Long John. You maniac. This is your friend, Imus in the morning. And I just called up to say eat it.
Imus in the morning.
6:19 in New York.
Rockin' them.
622. WNBC, I am the great by Mr. Cinnamon. It's going to be cloudy and cool today. Chance of occasional rain today. High between 40 and 45. Low tonight in the 30s in New York now. It is cloudy and 38 degrees. You know, I have never worked in my entire life any place a year without some kind of big, terrible trouble. I mean, I was here just ready to quit or get fired. And the only disturbing part about being here a year is that there's just, I seem to be getting along with them pretty good. Well, I probably can fix that. Do you remember saying last Christmas how this Christmas you were going to shop early, avoid crowds, and no more hit-or-miss presents for anybody, for your retired uncle lives in Florida, perhaps? Well, even though it can't help you with the shopping itself, here's just the right thing for your every man on your list. Machine-washable knit shirts with Celanese RNL triacetate. The perfect gift. Your father-in-law will say he finally found a shirt that fits him right. Now, if he can get a woman, your brother, Kurt, will love the smooth, soft, sensuous feel of his Darnell knit, and it'll probably keep him out of the army. Your cousin Bruce will go for the vivid colors, the elegant patterns, and Uncle Homer in Florida will write to say that he's so happy his Arnell knit shirt never comes back with too much starch because he can wash it himself at home. Giving a Celanese, well, he will also inform you that your aunt just caved in about a week before this. Given a Celanese Arnell knit shirt not only shows you care, it shows you know exactly what fashion is up to. And if you drop the right hint, you may get a lot of new Arnell knits yourself. Start today by looking at Capri shirts at Gert stores.
Hi, this is Murray DeKay. I'm here to offer my congratulations for the fact that you've been here 1 year, gainfully employed. And to start off with, of course, we want to take people back to Cleveland, where you came from to NBC, when hundreds of thousands of people showed up at the railroad station to see you off and say goodbye, and which only shows you one thing, Imus. If you give people what they want, they really turn out for it. It's fantastic. I mean, you've been here just like 1 year. I've been here in New York radio for 19 years, and all I've got from NBC so far is a sheriff's gone a she. We do hope that you will enjoy the gifts that your friends have asked me to present to you. Hudson and Landry on the coast have presented you with an all-night date with Bruce LaRue.
Hi!
And I'm sure you're going to enjoy that much more than you did with those bears and sheep you used to date in Del Rio, Texas. And then Dr. Frank Field has presented you with a certificate showing that you have increased air pollution in New York by 265%. That isn't too exciting, but either is Dr. Frank Field. And then the man himself, Geraldo Rivera, your friend, has come up with something special for you. Pork Chop has given you a certificate so that you can walk in Central Park with your sister safely. And for me, Imus, well, you know I love you. And all I can say from the bottom of my heart is... Polish creep.
I'm up in the morning.
Too bad that car wreck didn't work out, Murray.
For your love.
Oh, funky Ed Townsend for your love. I'm Imus in the morning at 6:29 at WNBC.
You know, in many ways, all holiday seasons are alike. Member FDIC, with over 85 branches in New York and Long Island.
Call a Long Island area code 516-271-2800. That's 271-2800. Or in New York, area code 212-939-7100. This is WNBC 66 in New York City. I am Imus in the morning. The news is brought to you by United Airlines. Fly the friendly skies of United. Here, returning from a week at Jungle Habitat, where he was hanging around with the sheep and kissing the bears, Charles McCord. Charles?
Thank you, Don. It's 38 degrees at 6:30. Commuters who ride the country's largest rail commuter line, the Long Island, face the full impact of a strike this morning. The WNBC news time is 6:32.
Here she is, singing and dancing her way from United Airlines into your hearts. Miss Pat, a great wide way.
The great wide way to California, yay!
I know what you're thinking, folks. Why high coach seats, right? And all that lounge space to spread out in. Not so high with the kicks, dear. It's an old thing.
The great white way, California, yay!
Plus a wide selection of food. Keep dancing, sweetheart. Yes, tantalize your taste buds with United's delightful dining. And relax to live radio and stereo music on United's Californians. You want to keep it down on the finish, dear?
The great wide way to California, yay!
Peace negotiations between the United States and North Vietnam resumed this morning at a suburban Paris location. White House aide Henry Kissinger and Hanoi official Lee Duc Tho seeking final approval for draft Indochina agreements.
In the morning.
I wouldn't take any more time off if I were you, Charles. But you've lost it, Klon. Helen ready at 6:36 in the dark. I am woman.
Woman, hear me roar.
Ready. 39 at WNBC. I am the great Imus of the morning. It's going to be cloudy and cool today with the chances of rain, maybe high between 40 and 45. Periods of rain likely tonight and tomorrow. Low tonight in the 30s. New York now it's cloudy and 38 degrees. A story from Crazy Bob in 60 seconds. A story from 1 year ago from Crazy Bob.
This is Marv Albert, and I'm here with Glenn Sather of the New York Rangers. And Glenn, a couple of questions that I would like to ask. In regard to Imus, I know that you are one of his biggest fans. Back a year ago, did you think, honestly, that he would last a year?
Well, that day when I hit him in your studio, I wasn't too sure, but he took the blow well and he stayed in the hospital a few days. But, I knew then that he could make the year
after he took the blow. From there on, it was no problem. Glenn, now that he's lasted a year, how much longer do you think he will last?
After he took the blow, he was a little shaky, you know. I think it did something to him. It started to scramble his mind a little bit. He slurs his word. He mumbles on the radio now. And I think that he's really hit his stride. And I can't see any way that he won't last for a long time in the big top.
Okay, Glenn, thank you very much. Glenn Sather of the New York Rangers.
It's time for Crazy Bob, boys and girls, with another exciting story.
Yeah.
Bob?
Thank you, Lance. Today's story, boys and girls, is one I like to call Pinocchio. It goes like this. Once upon a time, there was a lonely puppet maker named Giuseppe. Giuseppe made the best puppets in the whole wide world. But alas, boys and girls, he was very lonely. You see, Giuseppe wanted a little boy. A little strange. One day, Giuseppe made a puppet and he named it Pinocchio after a movie he once saw. The old puppet maker wished with all his heart that Pinocchio could be a real little boy. One night, a kind old witch came to the door and said, "Hi, I'd like to turn Pinocchio into a real little boy." And she did, boys and girls. Unfortunately, although Pinocchio was a real little boy, he was also a pathological liar. So the witch told Pinocchio, "Listen, creep, every time you tell a lie, your nose is gonna grow." Pinocchio offered an alternate suggestion, but the witch ignored his crude wish. As time went by, Pinocchio's nose and his nose grew and grew and grew, until one day he decided to go to Denmark and undergo a sex change operation. And he did, boys and girls. And Pinocchio grew up, he became a famous Jewish singer named Barbara Streisand.
Thank you, Crazy Bob.
Yeah.
Be here next time, boys and girls, when Crazy Bob tells us how multiple sclerosis chairman Oral Roberts plans to heal all of the victims and keep the contributions for himself.
I'm up in the morning.
642 at WNBC. WNBC. I am the great Imus in the morning. Weather in New York, cloudy and cool. Maybe some rain today. High near 45. Rain likely tonight and tomorrow. Low near 30 in Manhattan. Now cloudy and 38 degrees. For all you media freaks, I'm going to be talking to Howard Miller from WMAQ in Chicago, which is NBC sister station over there in the land of love and honey. And we're going to dispense with Marv Albert right now.
This is Marv Albert. Albert, and I'm here with Rod Sealing of the New York Rangers. And,
Wonderful. Rod,
I know that you also are a tremendous fan of Imus in the Morning here on Radio 66. When he first hit the New York market a year ago, did you actually think that he would last the year?
Well, first of all, who are you talking about?
Oh, I thought you were a big fan of Imus. Imus. I know Sharon Sealing always listens, and I guess she's very adamant about her thoughts against Imus. But I didn't realize. I thought everybody knew a big star like that.
Well, I thought that little star got put out a long time ago. I didn't think he was still around.
Well, he is. He's kind of around. You know, he's serving as an outpatient, and this is very fine therapy for him. Now that he's lasted a year, Rod, how much longer do you think that he'll be able to last on WNBC?
Well, my prediction, till the new year.
Till the new year. Thank you. Rod Sealing of the New York Rangers with a ominous projection for Imus.
You animals, with those guys on the Rangers that are just, you know, drag their knuckles on the floor and not try to be funny, meatheads. Feliz anniversario, Imus. That's what Abe Villarelli at Manhattan American Sales at 125 West End Avenue says. Anyone who says that can't be Parley Albert, can they? Even if he can't speak English. Even if I can't speak what he speaks. And anyone who has a crew of mechanics check a pre-owned car in 12 essential points before offering it for resale these days is okay. Here's why Manhattan American won't settle for being just okay. Take the car you purchased at Manhattan American to any mechanic of your choice. If he doesn't agree that the car is exactly as it was represented to you, you can take it back to Manhattan American within 48 hours for your money back. All of it. That's why West End Avenue and 66th Street is known as the corner of guaranteed cars. Manhattan American Motors. Manhattan American Sales. The Sidemans of cars. You might say they've got a complete satisfaction cornered there. Better visit Manhattan American Sales, just two blocks west of Lincoln Center on 66th Street. You could go today if you would like, and you could tell them that Imus sent you.
Imus in the Morning.
I had been thinking that the guys at Manhattan American Sales ought to give me a Gremlin with a Levi upholstery so I can have some kind of first-hand knowledge to tell you about it. Don't you think that's a real good idea? Boy, I do.
Albert Hammond now, man.
Got on board a westbound 747.
Never rains in Southern California. It's 9 till 7 at WNBC. I am the great Imus in the Morning. Here now is a conversation I had with Howard Miller. Howard Miller is the morning man, morning disc jockey at WMAQ in Chicago. And he often has on his show Mayor Richard Daley because they are very close friends. You may wonder why I was talking to him. Because I like him.
Hello.
Hello, Howard.
Hello.
This is Imus.
Hi, Don. How are you?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
Congratulations on that spread in life. It was just great.
Well, actually, that was not a spread in life, Howard. That was an ad.
Well, it was well placed.
Thank you. You still have your job there?
Yeah. Why? Are you looking for a handout?
Well, I don't know. You know, this is my anniversary show here today.
Yeah.
And I'm glad to see you're all choked up about it, Howard.
Well, I am. I'm turned on.
I've been here for a year.
Yeah.
Did you think I would last that long?
Well, it's not a question of that you would last that long. I presume that you have because management has been so busy that they haven't been able to go out and audition other talent that might be available.
No, we've had a lot of afternoon guys and all night guys.
Well, it is a hardship on management to replace people, and I suppose that's one of the saving graces of people like you in the morning.
Thanks very much, huh?
All right, Don, it's wonderful. Congratulations. I know of no one more deserving to be gainfully employed in a great radio station than you, and you're doing one heck of a great job.
Thank you, Howard.
Up the good work.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I'm in the Morning.
Insincere creep. I've begun to think this may be a little self-serving doing this today, but, you know, that's my act, so I'm just going to stick with it. The list of folks is too long for me to personally dedicate that record. The Stones, Get Off of My Cloud. It's 6:56 at WNBC. I am the great Imus in the Morning. Here's a letter that I would like to share with you that I received on my first show 1 year ago today. Dear Imus in the Morning, congratulations on your first show. I know a lot of my fellow Americans will be listening, and I would like to take this opportunity to tell everyone that I did not mean that a Negro could not be elected Vice President of the United States. What I meant was that a Negro running for vice president in the United States probably would get fewer votes than, say, his opponent. Which does not necessarily mean that he would not be elected vice president. It just means he wouldn't be elected vice president in that particular race. But, of course, there are other races, and I certainly feel that a Negro running in another race, provided, of course, that he got more votes than his opponent, who would not have to be a Polish rapist, although in complete candor it would sway some votes, could probably stand a real good chance of getting the necessary number of votes to get elected. Maybe. Sincerely, Ed Muskie. As it turns out, a Negro could not have been elected with Ed Muskie on the ticket. WNBC, 66 in New York City. It's 7 o'clock.
Imus in the morning, WNBC.
Yeah. Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
Hi, Johnny.
You know, kids get something wonderful when they get a Lionel train. They get Dad. My dad and I ran the Lionel Road quite a few Christmases back. And I can still hear the clickety-clack as our Lionel rounded the trickety-track. Yes, I had a Lionel when I was a boy. Now my boy's gonna have one for his own toy. Lionel, Lionel, the greatest little railroad in the world. Lionel, Lionel, now it has the mighty sound of steam. Chugging round the tree on Christmas Day, can't you hear that Lionel train? Can't wait till my boy gets to run that line. I'll never tell him that it's really mine. Lionel, Lionel, the greatest little railroad in the world.
Make this a Lionel Christmas.
I'm up in the morning.
7:19.
You've got your highest eagles on.
WNBC, I am the great Imus in the morning. You know, in many ways, all holiday seasons are alike. Security National Bank, member FDIC, with over 85 branches in New York and Long Island. Call on Long Island, area code 516-271-2800. That's 271-2800. Or New York, area code 212-939-7100. It's 722 WNBC. I am Imus in the morning. Judge Hangin, from 1 year ago, in 60 seconds. Do you know that knit shirts that you can get double the fashion mileage from? Do you know about them? Well, they're knit shirts with Celanese Arnel Triacetate, and they'll take you from the office to the movies, from a wedding to a football game, with the greatest of ease, the greatest of looks. Men all over have discovered that Arnel knits are both dress shirts and sports shirts, and they found that as long as they're in Arnel knits, they're dressed for the occasion. Because the Arnel colors and patterns are done so beautifully, so precisely. Another big word. They make a suit look a little more elegant. Slacks look a little more comfortable. Machine washable knit shirts with Arnel have a perfect talent for putting men at ease, whatever the situation. The Arnel fabric is so soft, so smooth, that men always feel good in them. And Arnel knits feel so, they just feel great. They never bunch up. And when dude wears them, always knows that he's just looking good. The minute time you discovered how far they can take you, take a look at Excello shirts at the Gimbel store nearest you. And I'm now for Judge Hangin.
On the wheel, the judge in.
Good morning, my fellow Americans. Judge Hangin comes to you this morning with a heavy heart. Before we discuss one of the crucial issues facing America, Judge Hangin would like to remind you that the law is our friend, and anyone who
hurts our friend should be beaten senseless. My fellow Americans, you hear it every day on Commie Pinko Bedwetter radio stations. Will President Nixon cancel the election in 1972? Will he run by himself with no Democratic opposition? Judge Hagen says, let's hope so, for there's much to learn. Take, for example, the recent election of South Vietnam's President Tu. There was a refreshing lack of controversy, a refreshing lack of mudslinging, name-calling, and smear tactics in that Asian version of the American way. Would not it work here in America? I mean, if it's good enough for them gooks, it ought to be good enough for us. Such an election would, in keeping with the president's phase two economic plans, drastically cut foolish campaign spending. We would see the elimination of the kind of divisive electioneering which polarized America in 1968. There would be no messy constitutional crises, no opinion polls, no biased commentators and newsmen to sway last-minute votes. And along with the surest and speediest television predictions in the world, no Hubert Humphrey. Remember, Judge Hagen is
110% American. Are you? I'm in the morning.
Judge Hagen from 1 year ago. It's 7:25, New York.
I'm in the morning.
Here now, Carol King. Bend a can. At 7:29 at WNBC, I am the great Imus in the morning.
Now, Mr. K, I love the idea of going to Europe this winter, but...
Excellent. Which one?
Oh, Mr. K, I'll leave the details to you.
In the time you took a winter break, your travel agent has over 900 great buys and tours to Ireland, Portugal, Turkey, and all the member countries of the European Travel Commission. I am Imus in the morning. I'm on the case. This is WNBC... 66 in New York City. The news is not brought to you by nobody. Oh, it is brought to us by who? It isn't brought to us by nobody. Well, we do have somebody to pronounce it. His name is Charles McCord. Charles?
Thank you, Don. 35 degrees at 7:30. To the moment, predictions of unusual traffic problems inbound to the city from Long Island have not become fact.
And that's in the morning.
When I saw you standing there.
May, May.
About fell out my chair.
May, May.
And when you moved your mouth to speak.
May, May. Imus in the morning. The Broadway number one local ERT train will pass 191st Street station in both directions. The 803 train from New Rochelle, scheduled to arrive in New York at 8:39, has been canceled. Passengers will board the 752 train from Harrison to New York at 8:37. Inbound Long Island Expressway is slow, headed inbound, passing the Cross Island Expressway. The Grand Central Parkway is heavier near LaGuardia Airport. Route 3 is moving normally. There are no mass transit problems to report yet. 1 year ago today, I'm Imus in the morning's first day on WNBC in New York. And 1,200 Hamburgers To Go was not
nothing more than another hilarious moment with I'm a Sinner Morning. Subsequently became a hit album. It went something like this.
Morning, McDonald's.
Hi, McDonald's Hamburgers?
Yes, it is.
This is Sergeant Kirtland of the Air National Guard, and I'd like to get some lunches to go if I possibly could.
We're not open for another 2 hours, sir.
Well, what time would it be? About 10 o'clock you'd open?
Or 10:30, sir.
Yeah, well, I wondered if I can give the order now. I need quite a few, and stop by this afternoon and pick them up.
Well, I'm just cleaning up. I'm the assistant manager. Maybe,
well, like to get, if I could, 1,200 hamburgers. 1,200 hamburgers is what we'd like to get. We got a troop movement scheduled one of the local colleges, and like to just get some lunches to go.
Just a moment. I'm going to have to ask my... just could you hold on for a second?
Yeah,
Sergeant,
fine.
Just a moment, sir.
There's a guy here, a sergeant with the National Guard, and he wants 1,200 hamburgers.
Hello?
What should I do?
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, listen, what do you think?
Well, we don't have enough meat or the buns for 1,200 hamburgers.
Well, can't you get some from the other stores?
I guess so.
That's the government, you know.
Yes, sir. I'll have to do that, sir.
I'll tell you what, why don't you just take the order and then get them as soon as you can, and I'll call you back in an hour or so, okay?
That would be good, sir.
What, all right, we need, huh?
Well, you want,
1,200 hamburgers. Now, listen, on 300 of those, I want you to hold the mustard, but put on plenty of mayonnaise and lettuce.
Yeah.
And I don't want any onions on those. And on 200, when I make that 201, I want you to hold the mayo and lettuce, but lay on the mustard and make those medium rare. And if you, on the first 300, let's see, on the first 300, if you can cook 275 of those rare with onions and mustard and mayo and no lettuce.
Rare.
You got that so far?
Yeah.
No lettuce. And it's okay to hold the mustard on those either. Don't butter the buns on half of those, but put butter on about 134. Let's see, half of 275 would be 134, right? And then the half of that, make it butter on the buns. We'll make it butter on the buns for 135 with no mustard or mayonnaise or lettuce or onions. Well, wait a minute. You can put lettuce on three of those and cook those medium well with no butter on the buns. And can we get some chocolate shakes for everybody? Hello?
I'm up in the morning.
It's 7:44 at WNBC. That was Millie Small. I am what you call your great Imus in the morning. Weather in New York, cloudy and cool. Chance of maybe some rain stuff today. High between 40 and 45. Periods of rain likely tonight and tomorrow. Low tonight in the 30s. New York now, it is cloudy and 38 degrees. I have on the phone one of my favorite people who I just woke up. Hello, Geraldo.
Hi, Don.
Try to pull yourself together, would you? I thought you'd be up and all ready for this with Marty to do the lip sync for you. You know, a lot of people don't know that Geraldo Rivera, while he's probably one of the finest newsmen in the country, and up for 3 Emmys, I understand, Geraldo.
Yeah. Yeah.
Does not speak a word of English. And in fact, Marty Berman just lip syncs everything he says. Geraldo, I'm not going to go on too long with this. All I wanted to call and tell you was that I appreciate that thing you did on Eyewitness News, and I wanted you to know that I have lasted now here in New York a year.
One of the great mysteries of the age. I was trying to contemplate your longevity, and I can only say that you fooled a lot of people for one time.